All right, so we have Tagil Ulenbekov versus Alan Nacimento. Nacimento has a 2-inch height advantage. So, from what I've seen from Alan Nacimento, on the feet, pretty fundamental, straight punches, all that kind of stuff. But what I've seen is that he's just very slow for a flyweight. Like, normally flyweights, you expect them to be quite quick. But he has like middleweight speed. It's just really weird. Just really slow punches. And yeah, he throws the snapping jab. He will pump out the jab a bit more if it is landing, as we saw in the Piva fight. 1-2, as I said, very fundamental. What he does do is throw leg kicks though, which Tagia doesn't address, and also he's just such a target for them because he has those skinny legs, he stands very tall, and his leg is almost straight, like his lead leg is almost straight, so it's like, hard to check. So, it's just such a target for him. And Nascimento, he does throw leg kicks. For Ulenbekov on the feet, he's no speed demon himself, really. Like I said, Nascimento was slow, but Ulenbekov, he's quicker, but he's not quick, if you know what I mean. He likes to be the aggressor, likes to come forward, pop the jab out. The jab, well, his lead hand does hang low, pops the jab out from the hip. And Nacimento, just really slow reactions on the jab, just slow in general. As I said, like Paiva was connecting with the jab on him quite a lot, and I think there was another fight that I watched that the jab was just landing a lot. And he's just, quite predictable with his movement. He will kind of back up in a straight line. I feel like Tagia will be able to back him up quite easily to the fence and work his wrestling, and we'll get into that in a sec. But with Nacimento, he does these big rolls, these slow big rolls and weaves, slow rolls, slow weaves to avoid strikes. Like, he'll dip his head in the pocket quite a bit, and he's just really slow with it. So yeah, just my takeaway from Nacimento, just slow on the feet. In regards to the grappling, Tagir, he's got very nice pure wrestling, very nice chain wrestling, but on his entries, he doesn't set up a lot of his takedown entries. He just kind of, goes in, reaches for it. It is what it is. But very nice wrestling game. Cuts an angle to finish a single leg around the pipe, high crotch single leg in on the fence, and in the clinch, outside leg trip. He's got takedowns from every area of grappling, and I think his single leg is definitely his go-to. But yeah, he's got nice reactive takedowns as well. Nice reactive double when his opponents are closer distance too aggressively. He'll catch a kick, work a double leg from there, look to push the opponent over, or just ground them, lift the hips up off the mat, and take them down. And Nacimento, he doesn't have too much problem with being on bottom. Like, he'll accept bottom position without too much resistance at all. But he is very active off his back. He has like arm bars, triangles off his back, I think, on his record. But one thing he will do when the opponent stands up in their guard, he'll attack a leg lock immediately. And Tagia, he isn't very active on top. Like, he's mainly just looking for control. He's basically just hugging you, really. He doesn't do too much damage on top. And Nacimento, he does have a bit of takedown. He has a bit of offensive wrestling as well. He has the whizzer kick and the clinch, where I think that's his favorite takedown for sure. But what I gotta say with Tagia, he's got very good get-ups. Got very good, like, technical get-ups. Good reversals as well off bottom. I don't know if he's gonna be able to reverse Nacimento, but he should be able to get back to his feet. He gets the butterfly hooks. He uses the guillotine grip, and he kind of threatens the guillotine, and that's what he uses basically to get off bottom. Or he'll get an underhook, shrimp out to a hip, and strip out from there. Actually, just get onto a hip and shrimp out from there. How these guys win fights. So for Tagia, he's got good offensive wrestling, good frame for the division, for both. Nacimento's 5'9". Surprised he can make this weight class with that frame that he's got. But yeah, it is what it is. How these guys lose fights. So for Tagia, he's got concerning striking defense, and for Nacimento, he's just slow, as we talked about. Path to victory for these guys. So for Nacimento, leg kicks, as we talked about before. Look for takedowns. If he does get you down, be active off your back. Look for submissions. Look for strikes off your back, because he's just mostly holding on, really. For Tagia, take the front foot, volume on the jab. The jab's going to be landing. Watch for the whizzer kick in the clinch. That's his go-to takedown for sure. And don't jump guillotine. I've seen him do that in the past. How I see this fight going? So I'm not high really at all on Tagir, but Nascimento, he seems to not have much structure around his game, and I think that's gonna cost him in this fight because at least I know what Ulanbekov's gonna try and do, and I know and Tagir knows what he's gonna look to do. But for Nascimento, he'll just have these periods where he just throws a jab, like just a jab, like just he'll throw 20 jabs in a row, or he'll just throw kicks, like 15 kicks in a row, or he'll just go for five single legs in a row without setting them up. Like he just seems to make a read and then really try to implement it, and if it doesn't work, he doesn't really have a plan B. But yeah, it just the structure in his game doesn't seem like he has much. Also looks like he has a bit of a padded record. We'll bring it up here. So yeah, 18-5, you know, not bad, not bad, not bad. The guy that he beat, 5-3, Hulin Paiva, we know Hulin Paiva. He's pretty good. It's a split win. You know, Paiva does have his downfalls though. 5-4, 4-5, sorry. This guy lost a split. I think this guy's decent. Yeah, we'll tank that guy. Motoya, 8-5, you know, not great. 9-10, you know, lost to this guy. He's decent. Well, I don't know if he's decent. He's probably got a padded record as well, but he looked pretty decent on tape. Bruno, this is a Russian guy, so he's probably got a decent record. Not Ukrainian. All right, so decent record, but still pretty journeyman-like. Where was that to? 5-6. Yeah, basically, like the way he's looking good is in these fights where he's facing someone who's like 3-5 or some shit like that. So you know, I don't know really how good he is. It's just the structure is really throwing me off. Tagir's win over Bruno Silva has aged like fine wine. Like Bruno Silva has great wrestling, and Tagir out wrestled him in that fight. Nascimento, he consistently gets out scrambled by lesser grapplers. From what I've seen on tape, he gets out scrambled a lot by lesser grapplers than Ulanbekov. And I believe what's his name? Tagir will be able to grind him out with his wrestling. I don't think he's going to have a hard time getting Nascimento down. And he could probably control him from top position. Just depends if he does work. You know, he does tend to just stall when he does get the takedown. Another thing for Nascimento too is that he's had 3 minutes fight time in the last 3 years, and I couldn't find that fight. Like he trains with DuBronx, Thomas Almeida, Moreno Bueno Silva, and DuBronx, Charles Oliveira. He has very nice striking now, like he has clean striking, but it wasn't always that way. Like he didn't used to be a fantastic striker. So we could potentially see some improvements in the striking of Nascimento because you know, people from that camp, they're improving their strike, and a lot of those guys are Muay Thai practitioners. If he could just sharpen up his Muay Thai a little bit, then, you know, potentially could be a decent prospect, decent ground game, and a bit of Muay Thai as well. You know, it could be a solid prospect in this flyweight division with his frame. But just going off tape, I have to favour Tagir. And I favour him on the feet as well. I think he's going to be the one coming forward. He's quicker too. I think the jab's going to be landing all day. And you know, I favor him in the grappling as well, so I think he wins everywhere. But with all that being said, I can just imagine this fight being closer than expected, kind of like the Bruno Silva fight. Like Tagir is probably gonna be like a minus 400 or something like that. Like I'm taping this in on the 23rd of August, but it's gonna I'm feeling, you know, Tagir is gonna be like minus 500 or something stupid like that. But you know, he never really represents that money line. He generally does get in quite close fights and quite competitive fights because he doesn't do too much in top position. So if you make him work a little bit, or if you make the striking competitive, then you know, he never really is going to represent that 500 or minus 400 price tag. All right, so if you guys liked the video, all that kind of stuff, so prediction is Tagir by decision. I think the line is pretty much correct. I don't think he's going to finish this guy. It's Tagir by decision. Yeah, if I was to play anything, it'd just be Tagir by decision there. I don't really want to play either of the money lines. I think the money line's pretty much correct. Yep.